We're joined now by the engineer of those game-winning plays, co-offensive coordinator Brian Harsin. Coach Harsin, that final drive, what's going through your mind?
Well, we needed to score, number one, and just what was going to be our best set of plays to do that. Just the way the game had gone and hadn't gone as we planned. So kind of going back before we'd gotten into it and just thinking, okay, what's going to be good based off the defenses that we've been seeing. And really just hoping that we go out, operate, and do our jobs in that situation there. And the guys did. You know, it was, I thought Case did a great job. We had a couple of plays early there. They were a little bit scary. And then guys settled down, and Case made some throws, made the fourth and sixth throw to Shipley, which was huge. And that was one of those plays that, a little bit like Oklahoma State, once we got the momentum, you could feel that we were going to move the ball. And then we come back with a couple more, and Mike, again, makes another great play, which we needed to do, and got us down there, and then we finished it off with the throw.
So it's third down. You go play action to DJ Grant.
Yeah.
Why did you make that play call?
Well, earlier in the game, we went and ran the ball down there and didn't do a very good job. They stopped us. And so they were packed in there with the same look that we had seen before to stop the run. And so, you know, not to put ourselves in that same situation, throw the ball, give him a chance. There's a couple options on that throw there for Case, and he did a great job. DJ Grant's actually the second read there, and he found him and got the ball to him.
You brought up Oklahoma State, a little bit of deja vu. What does this kind of late game success do for the confidence of your offense?
Well, one of the things, you know, obviously we want to put ourselves ahead. We'd always love to do that, start fast and continue to keep just pounding it and being physical and making plays and not be in that position. We happen to be, and I think one of the things it says about it is we can finish a game. It says about their preparation, their mentality, I think their belief that we can get it done. We've been able to do that. And so, you know, that's one thing that we talked about. We have finished games well. We have scored in our game-ending drives, you know, even the one against West Virginia, you know, and we lost that game, but we did score. And so that's a big part of what we do in practice is making sure that we can do those two-minute drives and be successful and know that we have to score and that we can be clutch in that type of situation there. So, you know, I think it's something just a credit to the players' mindsets that this is what we do every week in practice. Let's just go out and do our jobs and really stay calm and not let that anxiety get to them in those type of plays.
Case McCoy obviously gets a lot of credit for that comeback. But Marquise Goodwin, he kind of sparked happened in the fourth quarter. And we didn't see him on the edge until the fourth quarter. You said after the game that you need to set up those jet sweep type plays throughout the game. What needs to happen for you to be able to make that play call?
Yeah, you know, we obviously run that. Teams prepare for it. You try to see what they're doing. You try to see how they're going to play it. And we have several different ways to do it. Sometimes, you know, like in that situation, you just want to get him the ball. And could we have done it earlier and done those things? Yeah. You know, when we needed it and when we called it, they happened to work. But those are things that we go back and look at and always analyze and go, could this happen faster? Could it happen sooner? Sure, you know, those things that we need, those type of sparks. And Marquise is a guy that provides that for us. And so, you know, as games go on, whether it's those type of plays or getting the ball in his hand somehow, some way, he's a guy that's continued to make plays. And so, you know, as we move forward, you look at that and go, let's make sure that we do this a little bit sooner, get the ball in his hands quicker, and try to provide those type of plays in an earlier quarter than what we did in this last game.
You made the decision to pull David Ash from the game in the fourth quarter. How has he looked this week?
He's had a great week. You know, and so has Case. Both those guys, we said earlier in the year that we had two quarterbacks that could go play, and they've both shown that. I think David's responded very well in practice this week. He's come out. He understands that the game didn't quite go as well as he wanted it to. Guys have bad games. And, you know, it's not always on one player. And so he understands that, and the reality of it is just go back and do your job. And so he's practiced that way. He's prepared that way. Case has done the same thing. That's really our mentality as a quarterback group. Just do your job. This is what we need you to do. He's done nothing different from what we've done in the previous games where he's been successful. And so it's all about getting out there and getting a good start, having the right mindset, and everybody doing their jobs around the quarterback as well.
Jonathan Gray, what has he done to earn that starting job?
You know, Jonathan continues to get better. Still a work in progress, you know, like most guys on the offensive side. We're all about getting better each and every week. But he continues to play well in games. He continues to prepare well in practice. And I think for a young player, he's done a nice job of just getting his mindset to where he understands what to expect next when these games come up. It's going to get harder. The reps, he's going to have more reps in practice. He's going to have more reps in the game, how to take care of his body. Just there's so many things that go into it rather than just playing, and he's starting to do those things. And I think a credit goes to Joe and Malcolm, Jeremy Hills. Those guys that have played can help him and let him understand, here's what to expect now, you know, as we get later in the season. He listens, he understands, he's coachable. And so I think those things are what's helped him.
So I have been warned about the tortillas that get thrown in Lubbock. Have you ever been hit by a tortilla?
I've been warned too, yeah. No, not yet. And I don't plan on it either. I will have my head on a swivel when they come out, I'll tell you that.
You and me both. Coach Harrison, thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
It.